Well, good day there. My name's Paul Lyons. I'm from New Zealand. I'm from www.paintings.nz, and I'm going to paint a picture for you. So this is a twilight scene. I live near a gorge, the Manawatu Gorge. And there's a walking track in the hills beside the gorge called the loop track, and the painting this evening is going to be of a view of twilight seen on the way down from the gorge. Well, down from the loop track, back towards the gorge, I suppose, really. It's not terribly complicated, but might be interesting to do. So I'm going to have a purple sky. Starting with a dark purple at the top, but I think I might just spread the water around on the paper first, so that the wash will colour the paper fairly evenly. So it looks like it's a reasonably even coverage of water, and I'll remove water from my painting board and the edge of the sheet of paper, because if I don't, it'll form backgrounds. May form backgrounds anyway, but this should reduce the probability. So let's start with this next purple colour, and we'll add it's got more blue in it than I wanted. We'll add red as we get lower down, and then yellow. So that's gradated wash of some sort, and by holding the paper up, I'm allowing the paint to flow around a little bit. It's not flowing quite as much as I would hope, given the amount of water I thought I had on there, so take drastic steps, and we'll add a whole bunch more water to it. So you can probably see that the paint is flowing quite freely now. Try and cover over that big blob that was there. Now that's kind of evened it out a little bit, hasn't it? So maybe up in that corner of the painting where maybe my fingerprints have adulterated the paper. And I suspect that that's going to be not quite dark enough in the top corner, because watercolour has this propensity to dry lighter as the pigment particles meld, mix in with the the paper fibres. So it doesn't colour the paper fibres themselves, it just gets in amongst them. So at the time we see it, when we apply the water, when we apply the paint, it's sitting in a, I'm going to add more water, it's sitting in a layer of water and pigment on the surface of the paper. So we've got a pool of wet paint sitting on the surface of the paper, and then it still feels as though that could be darker up there. So then it settles down into the fibres of the paper as the water evaporates, and the fibres of the paper are not absorbing the pigment. They're acting as a tangle that the pigment sits in, but the fibres themselves remain white. So they show through, and really want that red lump there. They show through, and the net effect is that the colour gets lighter as the paint dries. Let that move towards the side of the paper. And it's kind of producing the sort of gradation that I wanted. Let's just move it around a bit more as well. Oh, there's too much blue in that. That was a mistake. So that was picking up the colour on the edge of the paper. Now, is there anything I can do to mitigate that? I'll try putting some water there, but that may be a compounding the error. We might be lucky, because I'm going to end up putting a cloud around about there on the paper, I think, in the end, some later stage. So that's not such a bad gradated wash. It's not quite as even as I wanted, but that's probably now if I'm really clever, I can hold one part of the paper horizontal while allowing another part to to run. So I'm trying to, so the part that's gone off the top of your screen I'm holding horizontal. You'll probably see that if I hold it up here. And then there's a bit down at the bottom that's more or less vertical. I'm trying to get the paint to run towards the horizon from on high in that part of the screen, or that part of the paper, which it's not. It's not really cooperating, so I think I'll just leave it. And I've also got a run there that I don't really want, or not a run, an edge I should say. So we let that dry. So, yeah, that has changed quite significantly, hasn't it? It's much lighter than it used to be. And that the reason I started drying the back of the paper is because of that back run that's appeared over there. So this I'm very unhappy about, and there's nothing I can do about it. It's there now, so there's nothing we can do to alleviate it. But we'll now have a go at producing some clouds. Let's have a go with a credit card to make the clouds. That's not going to work very well, is it? I need it to be much more soft edged than that, so before it has a chance to dry completely, do something to soften the edges a bit. See what happens there. It's not really behaving the way I wanted it to, so let's see if we can use a brush that's gone as hard as a board to soften. This is what happens. I get too enthusiastic about ideas and they don't always pan out. So the credit card idea was a nice idea, but it's obviously not the way to put clouds in the sky, particularly if you want soft-edged clouds. And I do. So let's just stick with that. I think I want something over on this side as well. All right, more drying. Yeah, that doesn't feel too bad. All right, now I'm going to have to try and do something to disguise that, I think. So the landscape is silhouetted and I've got neutral tint paint which looks almost black, but it seems to go sort of browny colour when it's painted on solidly, so I find that adding some blue and some red to it makes it go really dark. And if that's not enough, there's another trick that we can perform. But we'll just see how this goes. It looks as though it's going to work out reasonably well. So that's the... the black silhouette of the countryside. And I suspect that it's going to... it might work, it might not. We have to wait till it dries before we find out. It's left a terrible mess on the board. Not that I'm particularly concerned about mess on the board, because I can always wash that down. So now, we want to put in some of the plant life. Also silhouetted. A sort of yearning feeling, isn't there, to those... flax fronds, trying vainly to reach each other. We'll have another one that's got a change in its angle. So that was the easy part of the plant life. There's a more difficult part over here. Let's put in a bit of a tree sticking over the horizon, shall we? Just to give some variation to it. But the difficult part of the plant life is that there is more flax. But the flax flowers, which are silhouetted, and they're quite complicated little things. So on thin stalks, they're quite scrappy and sort of random in their shape, but if you get it wrong, then it just stands out like a sore thumb, doesn't it? So I'm trying to achieve something reasonably close to reality. I mean, I'm not doing botanical illustration, but these changes in the shape, or the bends in the stalk, there seem to be flowers at every bend in the stalk. And you don't want things to be too regular, which I seem to have just achieved on that particular little branchlet. Trying to brush against the shape of the brush to get furry fronds to appear. One of the things that characterises the way that plants grow is that they crisscross. There's no rule that says that the branches have to be evenly distributed in space as though they're espaliered. They don't do that. At least I suppose they do occasionally, but there's no rule that they have to. And things tend to look more natural if there's some overlapping of shapes. Start painting something and then you overlap a branch one over another, and all of a sudden it starts looking realistic. And it's down to nothing more than that. I kind of feel that might just about suffice. So I've still got that hard edge in the sky that I didn't want, but oh well. Such is life. Life's like that. And I'll need to wait and see how this dries and whether or not it's going to lose its very deep blackness, but I think it's going to be all right. The parts of it that are dry at the moment seem to be okay, so I'll just attack it with the hot air gun and see how that works out. That seems to have survived reasonably well. There's a little bit of variation in the intensity of that black, but I don't think it's going to matter all that much from a distance. I do think, though, that I want a bit of extra structure in this part of the painting. It's just a little bit stark at the moment, or at least it was a little bit stark until just now. I don't want people's eyes to travel out of the picture, so I'm trying not to have these lines going outwards. Oops, that's the one I wanted. There we go. Maybe one fairly dominant leaf developed a furry edge, so we'll defur it, as it were. There we go. I think that'll just about do us. Might just tidy up the top of this . There we go. Nice sharp point on it. Don't want to catch your finger on that or you'll end up saying ouch. All right, that'll do. Thank you. Let's now, where was that? That was Rangiwahi, I think, from memory. Another scene that just caught the light at the end of the day.